What's up, guys? This is Jess Brewhart here from Marvel Gaming On Location, and I'm here with Justin Wong. We're going to be talking about Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite. So first off, as a pro player, really high-level fighting game player, what do you think of Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite?
So I've been playing the Marvel series since I was 15. I'm 31 now, so 16 years.
So half your life.
Yeah, half my life. 16 years I've been playing the Marvel series. So when I saw this game, and I knew that Cromo Bean was working on it because he was a pro player, so he knew. He was from my timeline. Mm-hmm. He knew how good those games were.
Now, what's your favorite thing about the Marvel vs. Capcom series?
I think the best part about it is just like the versus series. Just like you have Capcom versus Marvel, right? You have Ryu versus Nova, right? Mm-hmm. You have Spencer versus Captain Marvel, right? And to see which one is the best, like, out of the generations and like the series, it's the coolest experience ever.
Yeah, I think it's so cool to see that crossover, to see Mega Man and Captain America right there next to each other fighting alongside. And speaking of which, what do you think of the storyline?
Ultron and Sigma came as one. I've been wishing for Sigma since Marvel vs. Capcom 2.
Awesome. Well, your wish came true.
Yes, he finally came out, so I'm definitely excited. I already bought the DLC and everything just because.
Perfect.
Sigma, I need to play him on day one. I need to play him.
I was just going to ask, who do you think will be your favorite character in Infinite, but would it be Sigma?
I would say my main character, when it comes out fully, it will be Sigma. But right now, I've been playing a lot of Nova and Captain Marvel. I definitely saw Black Panther, though, so I want to play Black Panther as well.
Which one of the Infinity Stones is your favorite so far?
My favorite right now is the Time Gem.
One's awesome.
Yeah, the Time Gem, I like to like dash around in the air, and then to activate, you get to do more crazier combos than already. Mm-hmm. So because of that, that's really cool. But then I'm also really interested in the Reality Gem, mm-hmm. because I like this little homing fireball just coming around and just like stalking the opponent.
Definitely. So as you know, there have been a lot of changes in Infinite from the previous games in the series. What do you predict for the future of the fighting game scene with regards to Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite?
So every Marvel game that comes out, it always changes. It goes from 2v2, 3v3, limited assist, and now you have the new one where you have usage of gems and the new tagout system. Mm-hmm. And because I think the tagout system is so unique and different, everyone is going to be crazy. If you're like one of those guys that want to grind it out in training mode, you're going to be stuck there for months.
Yeah.
Because when you see it in tournaments and competitive play, you're going to see so much of different combos. Every time when you see competitive play, you always see the same combos if someone's picking a character.
Mm-hmm.
But I think in this one, because there's so many combinations and gem usage, you're going to see different combos every single time. I could say I just made a Justin Wong combo.
Yeah.
So I think that's the coolest part about the game.
Yeah, I've been hearing that a lot. You can completely basically customize the game and play it the way you want to play it.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. It's been a pleasure talking with you.
Yeah.
Once again, this is Justin Wong here at E3. I'm Jess Brohart from Marvel Gaming On Location.